issues we've been dealing with over the last 3 years have been to try and stabilize our economy and make sure that it is more resilient than it has ever been. And so in 2015, I took the money to build this hospital. You cannot say, oh, thank you for the money, but we are doing a tender, and then take the money and give it to another contractor. Or if a Brazilian, if Brazil gives you money or China gives you money, they won't expect that you take their money and give the contract to a Brazilian contractor. And so there are some circumstances where sole sourcing is allowed under the law. But then I have given a directive, and that directive is being implemented, that every sole sourcing contract must be subjected to value for money. And so that's what we're doing. And so we give it to Crown agents. Crown agents will go through it and determine that we're getting value for money. But this anecdotal shouting about corruption, as if corruption has exploded under a particular government because we want to gain political traction, is not on. If you look at the corruption perception index, which is the standard measure for corruption in the whole international community, Ghana has continued to make progress every year. Because they don't look only at the perception. Of course, perception of corruption is high in Ghana because we have a liberal media, a more independent media than other countries. In other countries, they can't even talk about it. In Ghana, some beza in some secondary school goes and misappropriates money and it's banner headlines. We'll discuss it the whole day and the president will be blamed for it that some beza stole 1,000 Ghana cedis. The Auditor General support can say 1.3 billion missing. And in a lot of cases, it's probably that it's not missing, but they didn't follow the rules. And so the Auditor General makes remarks about it. But then for political gain, we add everything. Of course, some is stealing. Some people steal money and it's there. And the Auditor General recommends that they be dealt with or sanctioned. But in a lot of cases, the money is not lost, they didn't follow the procedure. So the Auditor General says, you didn't follow the procedure in the procurement of 100,000 worth of this. And then we lump all those figures together and say, 1.3 billion missing from Ghana's coffers. And so we need to put a lot of things in perspective. And the fight against corruption is for all of us. Recently, there's the issue of a Ford expedition. I've never been under the illusion that that vehicle was a gift to the state, and it's never been used for my personal comfort. In any case, I don't use Ford. I don't like American cars. I use Japanese cars. Toyota is my car.